through paths. Moving through paths. No one says, one says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نوية الأربعين، نوية الاعتكاف، نوية الخلوة، نوية العزة، نوية الرياضة، نوية السلوك. I will not be long because there is the زيارة of the Holy Head of Prophets. First of all, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم سيدنا محمد عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام said something important. All everything he say is important, but in this hadith I will mention one piece, small piece of the hadith, that how much Prophet loves and he cares for whom he loves. Because those who loves him, he cares for them. And it is mentioned that عن عبد الله بن مغفل قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الله الله في أصحابي فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم. الله الله في أصحابي. I'm leaving. Allah is the one who take care of my Sahaba. Anyone who loves them, فبحبي. He loves them because I love them. If anyone, ومن أبغضهم فبغضبي أبغضهم. If anyone came against them, I will come against that one. ومن آذاهم فقد آذاني. Who harmed them is harming me. ومن آذاهم فقد آذى الله. Anyone harmed them, he is harming Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ومن آذى الله فيوشك أن يأخذه. And anyone who harms Allah سبحانه وتعالى say something not nice, is فيوشك. On the verge of that person will lose his life and will die. Means we have to love the Sahaba of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All of them. لا نفرق بين أحد منهم. We don't differentiate between one and one. As some other people they differentiate and they harm. I don't know, they did not read that hadith. Those who hate Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Sayyidina Umar. We must be very careful in loving Prophet and loving his Sahaba. Because Allah will not be happy. And if Allah not happy, what will happen? You will disappear like the aeroplane disappeared.
الله سبحانه وتعالى loves, who loves his prophet and sahaba of prophet. So let us say we love them. Are we losing anything? Then Allah loves us. You love sahaba to Rasulullah?
Yes.
May Allah
ہم اپنے نبی کے
دیوانے
ہم ابو بکر و عمر کے
دیوانے
ہم عمر و علی کے
دیوانے
ہم غوث جلی کے
دیوانے
ہم داتا علی کے
دیوانے
نبرس کے ولی کے
دیوانے
ہشام کبانی کے
دیوانے
In another hadith, he say, عن البراء بن عازب, he said that I heard Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, الأنصار لا يحبهم إلا مؤمن. أنصار, those who supported Prophet in Medina, لا يحبهم إلا مؤمن. Only مؤمنs they love them. ولا يبغضهم إلا منافق. The only one that dislike them is a hypocrite, munafiq. فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ أَحَبَّهُ اللَّهُ. Who loves them? Allah loves him. وَمَنْ أَبْغَضَهُمْ أَبْغَضَهُ اللَّهُ. And whoever hate them, Allah hates that person. That is for Sahaba. What do you think about the family of Prophet? How much they come against the family of the Prophet? Not the old Khawarij, but the new Khawarij. Ah, yeah, mashallah, I have politician here. New Khawarij are whom? The new Khawarij. See? You're afraid?
Wahhabis,
no? Wahhabis. The new Khawarij. See, they want to destroy us. Yeah. You see how much Shaitan tried to. Of course, it's a sign. Everything you have to take a sign. What about the family of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Allah said in Holy Quran, "Kulla as'alukum 'alayhi ajra illa al-mawaddata fi al-qurba." If the Sahaba you hate them, Allah hates you. If you love them, Allah loves you. What you think about the family of Prophet? If you hate them, Allah will double his hate on you. And if you love them, infinite rewards Allah gives you. فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ أَحَبَّهُ اللَّهُ. Who loves them, Allah loves that person. Do you love the family of the Prophet or not?
Yes.
Raise your hand.
Allah.
Allahu Akbar. All of us. Angels, are you watching? Everyone is raising his hand that we love family of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we love Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we love Khulafa al-Rashidun, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Uthman, Sayyidina Ali, and all Sahaba. Agree?
Agree.
Allahu al-Muwaffiq, inshaAllah. And Ibn Abbas, he's the biggest mufassir of Holy Quran. Every ayah, when it been revealed, for what thing, issue it been revealed, or what incident been revealed, and what is the meaning that he takes out of it. SubhanAllah. He said that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لو كنت متخذا خليلا, because سيدنا إبراهيم is خليل الرحمن. You can say in Arabic, Ibrahim خليل الله. You cannot say Allah خليل إبراهيم. خليل means the friend. Good friend. Like brother. Not like brothers of today. They attack everyone, they attack, they hate each other, brothers, families, children, too much problems. Sayyidina Ibrahim is Khalil Rahman. You cannot say Allah Khalil Ibrahim, you can say Khalil Ibrahim Khalilullah. But Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in the Arabic grammar, you can say Muhammad Habibullah. And you can say Allah Habib Muhammad. So what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said? لو كنت متخذا خليلا لاتخذت أبا بكر خليل. If I would have to choose a good friend, Khalil, very close like Ibrahim to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I would have choose Abu Bakr for that. Those who they speak about Sayyidina Abu Bakr, how they don't feel ashamed? Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, that his iman, if it is put on one side of the scale, and all the sin of human beings, Ummatul Nabi, put on the other side, it's heavier, Sayyidina Abu Bakr. Heavier than everything that is on the scale. Allahu Akbar. إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ Allah mentioned him in Holy Quran. إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. Don't get sad. Allah is with us. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, if I would have take Khalil, I would take Abu Bakr. But he is my brother. بَلْ هُوَ أَخِي وَصَاحِبِي. He is my brother and my companion. Look how much his level is high, and all of us, these Wahhabis are not leaving us. And all of us, we are connected to him through the chain of the Naqshbandi order. It goes back to whom? It goes back to Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Sayyidina Ali. From one side Sayyidina Abu Bakr, and from another side Sayyidina Ali. That's why it's called as Silsila al-Dhahabiyya, the golden chain. Ya shukran lillah ya Rabbi. Alhamdulillah. حمداً يليق بحمده. الله أكبر. خلق الخلق فأعدمه. الله أكبر. خلق الخلق فأعدمه. Created the creation and he made it as if he's not existing. فأعدمه means finish, it's finished, it disappeared. خلق الخلق, he created creation, but one day is coming, this whole creation is like someone, أعدم الشيء, يعني cease to exist. One day coming, everything ceases to exist, even the earth, even Samawat. يوم تبدل الأرض غير الأرض والسماوات. There will be coming a day that the earth is going to be changed from another to another earth. That what not what you are seeing. Allah does not descend His throne on something dirty. Because in day of judgment, the arsh comes over, Allah descend, looking at His servant, judging them. Doesn't judge them on a dirty place. Has to be pure. So a new earth, that earth goes. That samawat, what you see, goes, new ones comes. Pure, pure ones. So, we go back to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tayyib wa yuhibbu tayyib. Awa yuhibbu tayyibun. Allah tayyibin. Allah tayyib. No translation. Tayyib means the best, absolute good, absolute sweet. And He loves the absolute sweet. Doesn't love something dirty. He loves everything clean. So when you love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Allah's sake I love Him. For my love to my Prophet I love Him. Then Allah loves you. So he said, if I would have going to take a Khalil, I will take Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, he is my brother and my companion. إِذْ يَكُرُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. When they were in the cave, he said to his friend, to Sahibi, to his friend, which is his brother, don't feel sad. Allah with us. Why you are worried? You know the Quraysh, those all of them running after Prophet to kill him. So he migrated to Medina. So he stayed in the cave of Ghar al-Thawr. The cave of Thawr. You can. People goes up, it takes 2 hours. Sayyidina Abu Bakr was, Prophet was leaning his head on the thigh, on the leg of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, on the leg of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Prophet was tired, putting his head on the leg of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Allah is able, kun fayakun, as He took him to Kaaba Qawsayn aw Adna, He can take him to Madinatul Munawwara in one step. Doesn't need to go through the desert and they have a guide. But this is for us to learn. That everything for us is not Prophet. So if Prophet has to take a guide and to go in the desert, you have to take a guide and go in your seekers of knowledge, to seek the knowledge, you have to get a guide. You cannot go by yourself. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ascending, he has Sayyidina Jibreel a guide for knowledge. To know all where he is going up in ascension, everything is knowledge there, ma'rifah. So he needs, although he doesn't need a guide, because the explanation says that when he reached Kaaba Qawsayn, when he reached a place that Jibreel said, I cannot continue, go by yourself. And he went, Prophet reaching Kaaba Qawsayn aw Adna. So when the guide show you, he guide you until it reached to Prophet, then his job is done. So all of us, we are lucky because we are connected to that one who is the companion of Prophet. Who is the brother of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We will be saved through the lineage of this golden chain of the Naqshbandi Sufi orders, and many other orders also, they have their connections with Sayyidina Ali, reaching to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, reaching to Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. And in another hadith he said, if there will be a prophet after me, there will be Umar will be a prophet. And these two, they were being attacked by Khawarij because they hate Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his Sahaba. وعن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها وأرضاها سيدة عائشة said قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم that prophet said look they say women they have no rights she was teaching Sahaba سيدة عائشة most of the ahadith from عائشة and سلمة how prophet in his house deals with children, with his family, what they heard from him, everything they is being taken from Azwaj al-Nabi, from the wives of Prophet. What she said, that Prophet said to her, أَسْتَحْيِ مِنْ رَجُلٍ تَسْتَحْيِ مِنْهُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ I always feel shy from one person. Prophet is saying that. أَسْتَحْيِ مِنْ رَجُلٍ تَسْتَحْيِ مِنْهُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ All angels, they feel shy from that man. And I feel shy from that one. He was so rich. He gave Prophet everything. And he married one daughter of Prophet. She died. He married after that her sister. Is Sayyidina Osman. Sayyidina Abu Bakr. He is to Prophet so dear that he is brother and companion, akhi wa sahibi, my friends. Sayyidina Umar, would we have been prophet if there is prophet after me? Sayyidina Osman, he feel shy from him. Sayyidina Ali, he said, ana madinatul ilmi wa aliyum babuha. I am the city of knowledge and Ali is the door. MashaAllah. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about Sayyidina Umar also that's important hadith that لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي مَا قَبْلَكُمْ مِنَ الْأُمَمِ نَاسٌ مُحْدِثُونَ Innovators, they bring things. That Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that there was in the previous ummah they used to do things either they say it relate to people or they innovate something good فَمَنْ سَنَّ سُنَّةً حَسَنَةً فَلَهُ أَجْرُهَا وَأَجْرُ مَنْ عَمِلَ بِهَا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ Whoever make something new in Islam and people, and it is good innovation, فَلَهُ أَجْرُهَا وَأَجْرُ مَنْ عَمِلَ بِهَا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ He will receive the ajr, for Allah will reward him, and reward him on the number of people that they will do it until the day of judgment. That's why they say there are innovation, it's bid'ah hasana. And he said, فَإِنْ يَكُوْ فِي أُمَّةِ أَحَدٌ فَإِنَّهُ عُمَرٌ If there will be in my ummah someone like that, he is Umar. Because he is the first one that he innovated Taraweeh in the congregation.
سبحان الله
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد. Now we want to have to wrap things up and to say that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said أبو موسى الأشعري قال that Prophet said to me, يا أبا موسى ألا أدلك على كنز من كنوز الجنة؟ Do you want me to show you or guide you to a treasure from the treasures of paradise? Yeah. You want?
Yes.
Everyone wants. Do you want?
Yes.
Say yes higher.
Yes. Yes.
فقلت بلى يا رسول الله. Of course, when a prophet is saying, I will tell you, I will guide you to find a treasure from treasures of paradise, everyone will say yes. Yes.
Yes.
Ladies.
Yes.
قال. He said, say, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Is a treasure. Is treasure of a paradise. Means there is no power. لا حول ولا قوة. There is no power and no way. Don't like try to find ways here and there. There is only one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قل الله. Say Allah. وذرهم في خوضهم يلعبون. And let them play as much as they like with their toys. It's not going to benefit them. What benefits them is to say Allah. So say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Now you have a treasure in paradise. It is hadith Bukhari and Muslim. Muttafaqun alayh. Is there any doubt? Any doubt? We have mentioned before in the afternoon, after Zuhr, one hadith, I will mention it now to repeat it. And Abi Ayyub al-Ansari radiallahu anh, he said that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, first of all, do you like slavery? No. No one likes slavery. And if you have the power or the money, wealth, to save slaves, can you do that? Yes. And how much was important to free a slave in the time of Prophet ﷺ? It's so huge to free someone from ubudiyya, from being slave to bad people even. Is that? Did you read the story of Sayyidina Salman al-Farisi? How much he suffered as a slave from Persia all the way to Iraq, from Iraq to Sham, from Sham to Madinatul Munawwara. He was being sold from one to another until finally he was sold to Jewish people. To Arabs, and Arabs took him from Sham to Madinatul Munawwara. There they sold him also for some Jewish people, and he sold himself because he wants to reach Madinatul Munawwara, because he knew from his first teacher in Persia, who was not Muslim at that time, that the last prophet is coming in Madinatul Munawwara. In a city between two mountains and lots of dates tree. He wants to reach there. So he was moving. They took him as slave, they were selling him. And he said, I served them with sincerity and loyalty, even though I am a slave, because this is the slave character. Look, subhanAllah, how much he was pure. It's not for easy that Prophet ﷺ made him from family, from his family. Because he suffered for the love of Prophet, and his age was long age that he was able to go through all this. I recommend you to find this story in the iPad and look it, and you know how much he suffered. So the hadith says that if you want, the meaning of the hadith I'm saying first, to free four slaves from slavery, from the children of Ismail, to free four, you will be, if you are able to free four, do you free them or not?
Of course.
Everyone will free them. And what a simple way Prophet ﷺ is giving you something as if to free, equal to freeing four of from slavery. How much Allah rewards you when you free one, when you free two, when you free three, when you free four. There is no reward less than paradise. He said, if you say this, as if you have freed four slaves. But say it. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. 10 times you say it, متفق عليه, Bukhari and Muslim. They say don't do zikr. This is zikrullah. And they say don't, they might say do zikr, but they say don't do zikr with number, adad. Don't make do zikr one or two times or three times. No, you cannot count. You count, it's bid'ah. But this hadith say, if you say it 10 times, as if you have freed four from slavery. He mentioned the number. Narai takbir.
Narai risala. Hum apne nabi ke
deewane.
Hum apne nabi ke
deewane.
Hum apne nabi ke
deewane.
Abu Bakr Umar ke
deewane.
Hum Usman o Ali ke
deewane.
Hum Ghaus e Jali ke
deewane.
MashaAllah.
If you say it 10 times, he mentioned 10 times. The innovation here, the bid'ah hasana, Prophet saying number, they say don't say number. From where they brought, don't break, don't make on numbers? Sheikh? How many prophets, big prophets? Five, it's number, it's not a number. It's a number. How many eyes you have? Two is a number. Everything is, you have to count it by numbers. Your nose, how many holes? Two. Your ears? Not two, more. Some people, they make two holes. Some people I see from top of their ears are all the way down. Many holes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from Abu Huraira, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم. Two sentences. They are very light on the tongue, very heavy in the scale. This is what we need. Because we are sinners, our sins are heavy. So Allah is giving us a way out. Prophet is giving hadith a way out. The two words that they are very light on the tongue, heavy in the scale, when he say heavy in the scale means they are heavy than your sins. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanallah al-Azim. Two words, two sentences. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. Subhanallah al-Azim. Some scholar they add Astaghfirullah at the end. So he say that. It's so easy on the tongue, you will get your balance, your scale in the day of judgment heavy. That if you say it one time in your life is enough. What you think if you do it 100 times? You take your whole community with you to paradise. Your all ancestors. If we say Subhanallah wa bihamdi, Subhanallah al-Azim, Astaghfirullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us. Inshallah. نرجو الله عز وجل أن ينفعنا بالقرآن وبمحبة الحبيب المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. And now we will open the holy hair of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Anything else? Anything? Huh? They are here? Okay. Then we the hair at the end then. Ziyara, or do ziyara now and then? Huh? What's that? Astaghfirullah.
جئناكم قصاد جئنا ببضاعة مزجاة.
اي دائما عندنا بضاعة مزجاة ما فيش غيرها.
قول لنا الخير سيدي تصدقوا عليها.
Anyone wants to renew his bay'ah, raise his hand. Sit, don't stand, don't. Everyone wants to see.
Just move back a bit.
أنا فقط رفعت يدي حتى هم يرون يدي ولا كلهم يأتون هنا. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أشهد أن لا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الذين يبايعونك إنما يبايعون الله يد الله فوق أيديهم فمن نكث فإنما ينكث على نفسه ومن أوفى بما عهد عليه الله سيؤتيه أجرا عظيما رضينا بالله ربا ورضينا بالله ربا وبالقرآن وبالإسلام دينا وبالقرآن كتابا وبالحبيب المصطفى رسولا صلى الله عليه وسلم وبشيخ سيد الشيخ محمد ناظم الحقاني شيخا ومرشدا. الله 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 حق الله 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 حق. إلى حضرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وآله وصحبه الكرام حضرة شيخنا سيد الشيخ عبد الله الفائز الدهستاني سيد الشيخ محمد ناظم الحقاني الفاتحة.
سيدي هذا العمامة
ها
نريد نتشرف سيدي من يدكم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
تحبون البيضاء والحمراء
اثنين سوا.
ماشي
انت في الليل. Is Hajj upstairs? Huh? Up, okay. Can you move backward for the Qawwali? So you also move. Right one. Ah, that one. Assalamu alaikum. How was your trip?
Alhamdulillah. All of your duas and blessings. How long do I have? 10 minutes, 15 minutes?
Yeah, yeah, half an hour.
Half an hour.
Thank you.